And hey everybody, it's SK again. Today we find ourselves in the wonderful city of Bastok, in the Bastok Mines area particularly, which has a very interesting layout. I never really realized this. Oh god, this is a good time to start sneezing. Hang on a sec! Oh god, where's the mute button? Where's the mute button? Oh, that was a good one. Excuse me. I need to find someone named Goomba. Let's see, who is Goomba? Goomba is like way the hell down there. Okay. Now, the reason I'm finding Mr. Goomba is because he is the start to the Dark Knight quest. Yes, I'm doing the Dark Knight quest. For those who are not aware, the Dark Knight quest is a pretty simple quest. It's actually a very, very easy quest to complete, but it has one of the most asinine things I have ever seen in a video game, which involves you killing 100 mobs, literally 100 creatures, with a sword. Does that sound easy? Yeah, sounds great. But you'll find out more on why this is painful later. Where I set out on his journey to rebirth. I'm not upset. I knew it had to happen sooner or later. He wasn't feeling that good, but he would always hide it whenever someone would visit. I guess he was just worried about the people he would leave behind. He was always like that. Aw, well that sucks. Hi! You know, we also had a visitor before where I left. Volker. That name is familiar. I apologize for bothering you again. I wish I had to speak with you about Zaid. Hey, where are the Musketeer's back again. What? Didn't the kid just say that you basically died? Alright, time loop, cool. Captain Volker, we Galka would also like to know of Zaid's whereabouts, but none of us know where he might be. You must understand, I cannot continue to perform my duties with a clear conscience unless I know what became of him. As you know, Zaid was one... Excuse me, as you know, Zaid is the one who should be leading the mythical musketeers, not I. Is it your uncle you think of when you say this? True, many Galka were upset by his appointment as captain after Rogrim disappeared, but... Or Raugrim disappeared. I do not feel the same way about you. As Zaid is different from Raugrim, you are very different from your uncle. It is not because of my uncle, sir. That bubbling, though. I'm glad to hear that. Now, I now feel safe in telling you that a Dark Knight was sighted in the Palboro Mines. He was very powerful, I am told. Then it is. That is all I know. So yes, from my understanding, Zaid is a Dark Knight. Like, one of the only Dark Knights, apparently, in in-game history sort of deal. So, why are there less Dark Knights since Zaid disappeared? Any idea? Well, Zaid did, in a sense, create his own version of the art, passed down since the glory days of Altepa. It is not something one can master with skill alone. It is said that only a few who contain the dark flames that burn within their soul, feeding off the sorrow and hatred, are chosen. Dark Knight, baby. Where's Angel? That's one of the last things I remember Were saying. Say, why don't you go find Zaid yourself? Maybe he can teach you how to become a Dark Knight, too. Maybe Were once told me... Though Were once told me that the road to becoming one is not an easy one to take. Oh, you have no freaking idea, kid. You have zero ideas. Okay, so... The goal of this is actually surprisingly easy. You talk to this guy, you start the quest, you go to Palboro Mines, you get on a boat. I'm on a boat, motherfucker, and all that good stuff. And you get a sword. You get a big-ass greatsword that apparently, I guess, has, like, mystical properties or some such. But the long and short of it is you get a sword, and you have to use that sword to kill 100 creatures before you can complete the quest. There are no flags. Remember, this is before the days of, like, quest markers and anything, so there's no quest flag. There's no quest tracking progress. And you can't use weapon skills to kill them. You just have to kill 100 creatures by beating it to death with a giant greatsword. Which is made worse by the fact that the sword has a 666 delay. How much is a 666 delay? Well, this has a delay of plus 96. You know, the battle axe I had, which if you guys actually, excuse me, do I have a great axe? I have great axes. So the great axes you guys have seen me using, the one where I'm just standing there for like 10 seconds not doing anything, that has a delay of 504. The greatsword has a delay of 666 motherfucking six. Yes, I know, ha ha ha. You know, like Satan references. So, without further, that's not where I wanted to go. Goosterberg, let's go to Palboro Mines. And first, before we do anything, there's going to be a moment of silence here because I really need to blow my nose after sneezing like that. I'm a professional. I do this for a living. I swear. You don't want to hear this, believe me. Oh, that's the stuff. Okay. I can breathe again. I love being able to breathe. Having access to your nose is a wonderful thing. I can't imagine why someone would ever cut it off despite their face. Okay, so... By the way, I'm cheating. I'm reading the wiki for this because, again, trying to find all this out on your own, since there's really next to no in-game information on this, trying to find this out on your own is exceptionally difficult, and everybody, and I mean everybody, uses the wiki. You have to use outside information in this game. It just doesn't work otherwise. Once there, board a ship on the third floor and you'll receive a two-handed sword. Equip the sword and start killing things. You need to kill at least 100 enemies in the sword in any area. Only warriors and dark knights can equip the sword once you have at least a cut of enemies. Once you kill at least 100 enemies by dealing the final blow, go to Bordeaux, you get a cutscene, will be triggered to send you as Dark Knight. So, yes, that is indeed the quest. It's go kill a bunch of shit, and then profit, basically. It's probably the easiest quest flag in the game, with the exception of Beastmaster, which is why I did that one first. But it's also probably one of the most monotonous because seriously, you're killing like 100 mobs. Just it's this is probably something I should not have been doing. Like, oh god, fucking Palboro Mines. I forgot how maze-like you are, you bastards. I don't even know if I'm going in the right direction. But I need to find the boat. I am vaguely aware of where the boat is. I do have Final Fantasy XI Atlas open as we speak, but for once, I would like to try to use it myself. Or I would like to try to figure it out for myself and not... Yep, well I know the boat is in that direction. So he's around here somewhere. I just gotta figure out exactly where it is. You can tell I blew my nose because now I have that sort of like chain smokery Tom Waits thing going on. Oh god, allergies, man, why? I never had allergies until like a few years ago. And it was a thing of glory and beauty and wonder, and I will never, you know, it's like that song from whoever the hell sings it. The one that's like, you know, on and on it seems to go, you don't know what you got till it's gone, pave over paradise to put up a parking lot and all that stuff. Because I have to hear that song like 10 times a day. It just repeats on loop at my store. But yeah, it's... You don't know what you got till it's gone. Like, you don't realize how wonderful it is to not have allergies until you start having allergies. And meanwhile, I'm sure there are people out there in the world who are listening to this be like, ha ha, suck it, you have allergies, now you know my suffering and all that kind of, you know, vengeance burns and all that good stuff. I can't really blame you, to be fair. But at the same time, it really sucks, man. I don't like this whole, like, constantly having to sniff and, like, the whole... constant sneezery Madu thing. I mean, the past couple of years, the only time I've ever really needed to... Fuck this zone. You know, the only time I've ever really needed to take any kind of, like, allergy medication was if I had a really bad sinus headache. Which you can get without necessarily having allergies, you know? That's just if air is bad, you know? That can happen. But I may actually have to start freaking taking sinus medication, because this whole, like, having a semi-cold without actually having a cold thing is, It's getting real old real quick, man. Oh, hi! Oh god, cough. Excuse me. Hi! Bone Eater, how are you? I will kill you. Because you may drop loot. Where you going? Where you going? There you go. Hello, good sir! With your great sword of darkness and all that good stuff. How you doing? Nothing? That's pretty badass. You know what? I just noticed that animation. Look at the quad of. He's actually holding the greatsword in his hand when he's not doing anything. That is actually a really cool animation. I have never noticed that before. That's pretty freaking badass. Did that motherfucker stone skin? What did he do? Why am I hitting him for literally zero damage? I almost two-shot him beforehand. So, what? Audix Quadiv uses invincible. Oh, he's a goddamn paladin. Well, the paladin's dead. I said, the paladin's dead. There we go. A pair of coarse gauntlets. But do you? Oh, that's terrible. Why would you ever want that? They give you -3 evasion. Is it because it has super high defense? Also, if you ever have to go through Palboro Mines and you don't want to be a dumbass like me and walk through all three floors and then all the way back through, like, Gustaberg and all that kind of stuff, this motherfucker exists. Watch this. Check this shit out. Q, I'm on a boat! This is the greatest thing in the history of mankind. Well, I mean, not the greatest thing in the history of mankind. It's not even close. But it's really cool because you can get onto this boat and this will take you to freaking Zerun Mines in the middle of... That was new. It will take you to Zerun Mines in the middle of Bastok, so you don't necessarily have to worry about running through like three zones worth of stuff. There's actually some thought put into this, and I can appreciate that design-wise. Why are you looking at me that way? Have you never seen a Dark Knight before? No, but that's a badass sword. You say Goomba told you about me? That child is always crossing the line. It's unfortunate what happened to Array, but I see Volker has not changed. I thought I might visit the Mines District, but if they are still there, I should probably not. And why is it that you sought me out? You seek training to become a Dark Knight, perhaps? Yes, I sense that you have already felled many enemies. Yes, yes, blood boils and all that good stuff. But the way the Dark Knight is not one to be taken lightly, it is a hopeless road where anger and sorrow are your only companions. I am Vengeance, I am the Knight, I am Zayd. But if you wish to become one, then take this sword. Let it feed on your bloodlust and the blood of your enemies. I must go. I have some business to attend to in Bado, the Quad of Stronghold. Sate that sword's hunger and we shall meet again. So it's like fucking Frostmourne? Is that what this is? Also, Chaosbringer? Fucking awesome name for a sword. Anyone who says otherwise is lying! Okay, I think I'm going in the right direction. I've been through Zerun Mines enough to kinda know where I'm going. Yeah, I think this is it. It threw me off because it started me in an area that, you know, you're not really used to going to if you just walk around where you're supposed to go. Now, here comes the fun part when it comes to this particular quest. Because this particular quest is going to be me killing 100 mobs, as mentioned. That may not sound like a lot, but remember that there is no quest tracker. Literally nothing. Wait, why is there a circle on the map? Since when was there a circle on that map? Like a little, like, squiggly smooch where someone's like, hey, look, this is where the mines is. That's really weird. It also gives it a nice little touch of authenticity, maybe? I'm not really sure if that's the right word. Oh, I completely forgot to mention as well. In this video, you might notice that the visual quality is a little bit different. 60 FPS, motherfuckers. 60 whole FPSs, man. It is the most amazing thing ever. I did not realize that there was actually a plugin with the Windower program that I was using that actually uncaps the frame rate, or basically allows you to get a 60 frame rate cap. And it's interesting to find out that the game actually pretty much was designed with 60 FPS in mind because, I mean, look at it. It runs perfectly fine. It doesn't run twice as fast. So it was planned with 60 FPS in mind, but they must have capped it at 30 because, you know, PS2 era and everything, you know, nothing really saw 60 FPS, you know what I mean? So, but it's really interesting. I didn't realize how much I needed 60 FPS until I saw it and then I realized, oh, this makes life so much easier. In fact, the first time I tried it, the first 30 seconds or so of me having this 60 FPS option enabled, it actually kind of made me a little bit nauseous because I really wasn't used to how smooth it was moving, so it kind of made my head hurt. Has anyone ever had that before? Where it just, your brain is just kind of like, nope, I'm not a fan of this, don't do that. Yeah, I was at that point. But I got over it, and now I have gotten used to its majesty. Look at this. 60 whole FPS. Like, look at the menu commands. Look at how smooth that menu transition is. Look at that. Double the frames, double the fun, something something double mint gum. Okay, oop, didn't want that. Change jobs. So let's go warrior and just monk because I can. And I'm doing that because the weapon that I'm being given is only warriors and dark knights can use it. So, in order to use it, I've got to use the Chaos Bringer. Oh, rune knights can use it as well, but that doesn't really help me any. This sword is pretty fucking awesome looking. I'm being completely honest here. That's pretty fucking cool. And now comes the most monotonous thing in the history of mankind, which is going out to... Well, pretty much I'm going out to, you know, Nublet land here and just attempting to one-shot everything. And honestly, the funny thing about the way the skill-ups work, especially in this game relative to other places, is that you're not really going to be one-shotting creatures. Sure, you're level 25 comparative to a level 0 or a level 1, such as it is, but you ain't going to be, you're not really going to be one-shotting anything because the damage you do is relative not only to your level, but it's also relative to your skill. So if your skill is at 0, like mine currently is, guess what? You're not going to be doing any damage. So you need to be at the appropriate skill level in order to hit a mob, because that's what it's relative to the mob's skill level. And then, once you are at that or at the higher rate... So basically, like, the level is almost kind of irrelevant in a way when it comes to weapon skills. It just allows... The physical level is just sort of like a vehicle to let you get the high enough skill ups you need, or the high enough skill points you need to be able to hit the mobs you want to hit, and also, you know, not being two shot. Like, look at this. Like, look at her running. Like, she's actually sort of like bobbing back and forth because this thing is so heavy. The sword's bigger than she is! Look at that shit! This kind of makes me want to do this quest as a Taru Taru. That would be the funniest damn thing in the history of mankind. Okay, I'm gonna actually... Excuse me, motherfucker? Where are you going? Oh yeah, this is gonna be interesting. And what I'm going to do, because I'm going to lose count by talking, is that I'm actually going to make... hash marks. Not hashtags, hash marks. By the way, this is 666 delay. Yep. That is 666. Get the... Bark out of my way, whatever you call this thing. What do you call that thing? Paper towel. There we go. Get out of my way, paper towel. Okay, that's 2. Oh, this is gonna be a long episode. So how are you guys doing today? Well, I hope. We'll say she's kind of badass looking with it. The sword is, again, bigger than she is. And I'm gonna be tempted, again, to record this with a Taru Taru just to see. Like, could you imagine? I understand that for size purposes, everything is, you shrunk up or down. 3. But it would be hilarious if Zaid had handed a Taru Taru a sword that's like this and it's like, figure it out, motherfucker. Take care of it. Many whelps, handle it. Now. Excuse me? What do you mean you must wait longer to perform that action? Go F yourself. Get that berserk going. Which does literally nothing for me. Oh shit, was that 5? I think that was 5. I've already lost count. God damn it. Well, hopefully that's 5. If we do 101, I think we'll be fine. Whoa. Holy frame rate drop, Batman. Maybe this is the downside of uncapping your frame rate, because now it's like... Excuse me? There we go. That's 6. Wow. That's... Alright. Remember how I said it's, you know, didn't seem to be capped at... It may have been used to be words? There's a sentence in here. Okay, let's start this over. Sentence structure. Remember how I said they didn't seem to cap it at 60 FPS and, you know... Or they capped it. They want the words! Sentence structure. They planned it to be 60 FPS, but they capped it at 30 FPS. I may have been completely full of shit in that regard, because I'm pretty sure that it shouldn't be doing this, where it's visibly slowing down when I'm going to different areas. Like, this is... Can I attack, please? I actually put up the FPS counter so you can kind of get a look at this in vivo, so to speak. That's 9. I can see the rage now. You missed 2! Well, that's entirely possible, but I'm bad, and I feel bad. Excuse me? Come here. The worst part about it is I can't use a weapon skill. That's, like, the worst part about all of this. That's 10. Alright, 10 down, 90 to go. Oh, God. What have I done? But at least I'm one-shotting them. That's a plus. I remember watching Mr. Happy trying to do this, and God love the man. He had, you know, 45 minutes of commentary of just the most bullshit commentary of all time as he was fighting these things and not one-shotting any of them unless he got a super lucky crit. I'm just gonna put that as a 12 and just wait, like, the requisite 15 seconds to actually make another attack. Thank you. Poor tunnel worm genocide. They're only, like, I'm not doing anything. I'm just a worm. I didn't do shit. Also, I like tunnel worms because, like, they die in one hit. That's, like, my favorite thing right now. It shouldn't be, but it is. Also, does anyone... You missed. Oh, you bitch. So, does anybody know, when it comes to the delay of these weapons and everything, especially with something that has such a huge delay like this, does starting and stopping combat reset that delay, or is it just a matter of, you know, you got through 100 of your 600 delay by killing this mob, so when you start combat with another mob, you're in, you know, 101 of 600 delay, you know what I mean? Did that sentence make any sense? It may not have, but I promise I'm trying to have it make sense, as difficult as that may be also. That damn slow-mo. Them slow-mos, yo. That was 15. 85 to go, people! That doesn't seem insurmountable at all. Oh lord, that frame rate. Is that because the zone is so big? Do I have to draw distance too high? Like, what the hell? Did it always drop that low before I uncapped the frame rate? I'm a little bit scared. I'm being completely honest, I just unlocked the frame rate, you know, in my Mog House and was like, this is the most glorious thing I have ever seen. Oh, that's 16. This is the most glorious thing I have ever seen. You can't take this away from me, no way, no how. Also, I missed quest trackers. I have never missed a quest tracker more in my life than right now. Because, motherfuckers, I am counting up to 100, and while that's... Yeah, I know, like, lols, kappa. Not necessarily hard. I'm counting up to 100 for killing mobs. Like, 100, that's a lot of mobs to kill, man. That's a lot of mobs to kill. That's 18. Yeah, 18, okay. I had to remember for a second, and I'm like, what is the little weird double triple H thing supposed to mean? It means that's 5. That's how you count, right? That comes after 4? Yeah. And I will say right now that if anybody actually sticks through and watches this whole thing, start to finish of me killing mobs for like 45 minutes, you are a golden goddamn god. Either that or you're just using this to fall asleep with, which I can't really fault you for because I do that shit all the time. That's how I watched Mr. Happy's video of this, because it was just sort of interesting to kind of be lulled into a whoa. Did you see that shit? Yeah, I'm spazzing! Spazzing! Okay, you're gonna be 21. I'm running out of desk space. I'm gonna scoot you over here so I have more room to do that. Okay, that's 22. Tunnel worm! That's not a tunnel worm, that's me. Okay. So attack and kill thine tunnel. Okay, that's cool. I'm just gonna put you as 23 so that way in the next 15 seconds when I kill you, it will actually do what I want. Maybe. Please. Also, what is the delay relative to, like, actual time? I always thought it was just nope. That was 23. Don't add to it. I always thought it was delayed to, like, tenths of seconds or something like that. You know, 100 delay was 100, you know, 1 second, basically. And, you know, 2 delay was 2 seconds. 150 delay was, you know, 1.5 seconds, etc., etc. Boom shakalaka! That is 25, bitches. We are a quarter of the way there. Isn't that a nice feeling? That little bit of... What am I trying to say here? That bit of progression, so to speak? It's great, isn't it? Even though I'm walking around with a giant sword that's like, because look at this. Look at me. Like, look at this shit. I'm like bobbing, man. Look at that. Okay. I may also be starting to lose my mind. Dingbats! Oh, what am I doing? Hold the fucking phone. Objective list. Combat. Jugner Forest. I'm in South Gustberg, yeah? I should totally put this on. Does it actually? It fucking counts. It's so stupid. I love it. I don't actually have to get experience to get bonuses for, like, farming in an area. Which, oops, I just hit my microphone again. I'm sorry. I'm trying to, like, scoot and get untangled. Oh, God. Wires, please. Okay. Whoa, that frame rate dropped, though. Oh, God. Was that an- oh, fuck it. Alright, I'm just gonna say that's 23. It's probably not, but I'm gonna say it's 20- well, that's 24. That'll make things even in case I accidentally double-counted something. Again, I would direly wish for a quest tracker at this point. This is why quest trackers were created, because for games like Final Fantasy XI. So that's 30. But I'm assuming anyway that they created this- these records of eminence for these conflicts. And they did not tie them to experience gains specifically because people who were farming a lot may require this. Oh my lordy Jesus. Okay, hang on a sec. I want to test something. Whoops. Config frame rate divisor 2. This drops it back down to 30 frames a second. Which is about correct. You know, I mean, it's the same here or there. It caps it at 30 frames, whereas console, oh no, config frame rate divisor, I can't spell, 1 caps it at 60, which is fantastic here, but when you get to here it's like, oh my sweet baby Jesus, because I guess the game is assuming that you're going to be at 30 frames a second. So if it's capped at 30 frames a second, it's not going to drop frames, you know what I mean? Or it's not going to see slowdown, so that's probably why they capped it at 30 frames a second, because they assumed that there was going to be some, like, mad, massive slowdown. Or my computer is just, you know, hot garbage. That is entirely possible as well. Okay. So many chests, man. So little time. That sounds like a name of a really bad porno. Dingbats, where you going? Dingbats, come on. Come on, Cletus, where you going? There you go. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 31. Okay. I only got 69 more to go. I said I only have... oh my god. That was like 12 seconds. So in that case, in terms of the delay, is the delay actually double what a second should be? Like I said, I thought 100 delay was 1 second. You know, 200 delay was 2 seconds. So is 1 delay 2 seconds, 2 delay 4 seconds, 6 delay, you know, 12 seconds? So that means this thing would have like a 13 second fucking recharge timer or something like that, which is stupid. Oh god, my pen. I need you. I require you for things. There we go. Come here, fucker. Thank you. Give me a damn buffs, yo! I mean, it's stupid that I'm using Berserk against level 1 mobs, but I don't care. Just give me experience, that's all I require. Just let me perform the action I require- oh god. Now, for the sake of asking those of you out there who have used this uncapping feature in Windower before, is there something I need to know about, you know, making sure it doesn't do this thing where it drops to like 35 frames per second and makes me start running like I'm on some kind of psychotropic? I don't think psychotropic was the right word, but hopefully you- oh my god, bats, why? But either way, hopefully you understand what I'm attempting to say. Attempting is the key word in this, I assure you. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 35. So I'm at 37. I've kind of stopped counting what the hashtags are. Hashtags. What the hash marks are. But I'm just doing them on road anyway, so that way I can just sort of mentally... You bitch! Alright, that's cool. I see how it is. I need to provoke you. What do you mean I must wait longer to perform the action? Is it like 5 seconds? What the hell is your dealio? Okay. There we go. Oh, you're back, huh? Alright, that's cool. Come here. Come here, I said. Come here. Thank you. Do I have to turn settings down or something? Is that the trade-off to this? That the draw distance is too far or something? Config. Gameplay. Miscellaneous. Character models displayed. Miscellaneous 2. Flipping plane, what the fuck does that mean? Well, this is gonna be interesting. Now we're going to, like, tech support with SK. Yay! Conflict Gustaberg, 4 of 10. Wait. No, that's right, I didn't start it immediately, so that those numbers are not going to mean anything. Oh, I love you, Tunnel Worms. You give me the best one-shots. Please let me attack. Thank you. Config. Just a base plan 3D view. So that. Background aspect ratio. These mean nothing to me. Like, where's the damn animation draw distance? Hey, 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 hey! Hey, Beavis. Okay, fucker. Let's just do this then. I will provoke you. And then I kill you. Infidel. Okay, the nice thing about the dingbats is that when I miss, I can give me 15 seconds to actually look through the... Okay, never mind, I killed him in one shot. Fuck me. But that's great! I'm okay with it. Excuse me. Excuse me. Thank you. Why? Why do you insist on running the moment that I come? I mean, that's fine. It's self-preservation instinct and all that. I can dig that. But, like, for real, for real. Effects. Mouse camera. Global. Oh my god. Okay. This is going a lot faster than I thought it was, to be completely truthful. 8, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45. Okay. I'm at 45, guys! I'm 32 minutes into the video and I'm already, like, halfway done. That's pretty baller. Don't you say? Please. 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 Let me attack. Thank you. I really kind of want to destroy one with a weapon skill, but I know that's not going to count, and I don't want to do anything to elongate the process if it is not necessary to do so. Alright, Stone Eater, can I kill you in one shot? No, I cannot. That is unfortunate. But that gives me seconds. Precious seconds at that. But seriously, why is it not in the configuration? Character models displayed. Oh, that's clipping plane? That's just the fucking draw distance? That's the goddamn draw distance? Really? That's grok bullshit. Wait, did it suddenly turn up because I turned it down for half a second? Am I misunderstanding something here? I don't know what I did, but I think I just reset something in my computer or my game or something. I am confused. But I'll take it, I guess. Yeah, yeah. Like, it's acting perfectly fine now. Alright. That's, like, the weirdest shit of all time. Sure! Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's 9, so that's 45, 50. I'm at 50, bitches! I'm halfway there! We're halfway there, boys! It's amazing. Yeah, I think I actually did just, like, fix something in the settings by trying to just uncap and then recap it. all of a sudden it's just sort of like, oh, okay, I don't have to load the entire zone at once. No, you do not have to load the entire fucking zone at once. Unless I had... Oh, did I have something else? Maybe I had another plugin or something that was loading more than what the max of the game was allowing you to, and the game was having like a shit fit or something. Is that something that... That is something that's available, right? There's like a plugin that lets you see farther than max distance or some shit. And if that's the case, holy shit, this game is unoptimized. Oh my god. That's spazzing. Look at that. I'm fucking Neo's from the Matrix, guys. Shut up, don't look at me like that. Welcome to my slow descent into insanity here. As we wait. I want to time this, right? Thingy, get off my phone. I actually want to time this. So you don't see me doing this, but I'm actually bringing up my phone right now. And I'm seeing if I can find... Where is it? Calendar, camera, clock. God damn it. Why do I have to be an 85-year-old lady? Clock. Can I use this for a timer? Stopwatch! Excuse me? No. Alrighty. Let's go and... Never mind. That didn't work. Okay. I one-shot it. That's right. I one-shot these things. I mean, that's a good thing, right? Come here. Shiza! Minelli! Now I'm one-shotting you motherfuckers? I mean, when I want to have interest in actually timing to see how long it takes between shots? It's like 10 seconds. Reset. Or something like that. The funny thing is it actually started at like 3.5 seconds. So I have no idea how long it actually was. God damn it, Beavis. Alright. That might be off by half a second. But oh well. Yeah, it's like 11 seconds. So it's gotta be... divisible. It's gotta be like 100 delay is like 1.5 seconds or something like that. Something to that effect. But hey, I learned something new today. Neato. Is it anything relevant or anything that improves me as a person? No, not really, but you know, it's like knowing the circumference of the Earth, which by the way is 24902. Thank you, Mr. Vathis. And yes, the Earth's circumference is 24,902 miles, just like... Let me think, what other bullshit things did I remember from my 10th grade history class? The Treaty of Versailles was 11-11-1811, so November 11th, 1918 at 11 a.m. Yes, I actually remember that. Socrates! Was it Socrates or Aristotle? One of those motherfuckers said to question everything, question authority. It had to be Socrates. Wasn't he supposed to be like the fat bastard that... You know, that gave zero fucks sort of thing. If my understanding is correct, everyone kind of assumes Socrates is this, you know, this great historical figure that was, you know, refined and aristocratic and well-learned and everything. You kidding me? Like, actual Socrates? Like, the historical Socrates? If you read the history portion of it. Socrates was basically like a homeless bum that was just like, fuck everything about society. All you suck. You don't know anything. You know, all you guys are fake. So yeah, he was like fat, bald, ugly, unkempt. He was basically your hobo behind the 7-Eleven, you know what I mean? But, you know, 2,000, 3,000 years later, people still know who he is, so... You know, meanwhile the fat hobo behind the 7-Eleven is basically drinking his liver away. I mean, you know, whatever floats your boat, I suppose. I don't even know what the fuck I'm at anymore. I've long since lost count. The insanity is starting to take root. Save me from this madness. Save me from the nothing that I have become. For the love of God. Wah. 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 Thank you. I wonder if my ability to start and end combat is actually dependent upon the delay of my sword, at which point that would explain why there is such... and rather exorbitant delay between how long it takes for me to attack between mobs. Maybe that's how they solve the issue, so it doesn't necessarily reset your delay to zero, but it just says you can't attack again until that weapon delay has reset. Because holy mother of crap. Well, no, because that didn't take like 10 seconds. So I'm full of shit again. That's cool. Stay. What am I getting out of this anyway? I'm fucking gaining experience for this. That is so stupid. I'm fucking level 29, guys. When did that happen? I'm 1700 experience points into level 29 and I'm fighting level 1 mobs. That is so stupid. I love it. I'm actually getting something useful out of doing this. The insanity is slowly. I'm writing that down because that bears repeating, slowly. It's slowly tapering away. That basic insanity. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, 60, 65, 70. Oh my god, we're 60, we're... No, 70. Wait, no. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, 60, 70. Yeah, 70. We're 70. We're 70 mobs into this. Oh god. There's only 30 more mobs to go, guys. 30 more mobs before we can go to... Oh my god, I have to go to Badil. Fuck! I forgot that tidbit. I have to go to Badil. On another note, fuck Badil. That's not fuck bidet. I hear those are actually quite useful. A little bit weird, but useful. I know, I'm like an American. I'm a dirty, disgusting American. Whatever, that's fine. And say we have universal healthcare, but kick! Where is... There it is. Where is things? There is things. Kill all the things. Oh, it's so nice to actually have... Okay, I can turn this off now, since the frame rate isn't going batshit insane. Excuse me! I didn't want you to do that, but okay. Oh. Count that. You know the worst part about this thing right here? This quest? I know you'd be loving this shit right here also. Yeah, thank you for trying to run, but I'm going to chop your head off. As is. By the way, I'm not even touching these chests. Partially because there's nothing I can get from these that are useful. Maybe the occasional copper ore, but fuck that, to be honest. Beyond that, if I would actually unlock all of these chests, I would be here for like 4 fucking hours, man. And I ain't got time for that. I got work in like an hour and a half. Well, it's like 2 hours. But I need a little bit of time. I need like a half hour to get there. And another, you know, 15, 20 minutes to get dressed. Because I can't go there naked. Despite all evidence to the contrary, I'm sure at the tat-tat pen, you stay where you are. Yeah, I had to have something going that actually increased my draw distance. Is that something you can, again, is that something you can have? Now I'm curious. Uh-huh. That's another thing. And another one. Okay. So how about you do me a favor and come to me, Hornet? Thank you. Let's see. Windower. Draw distance. How does that work? Draw distance. Just the draw distance. So why the fuck do they call that the clipping plane? That doesn't make any damn sense. What does that mean? English, me speaking it good. It's inside the config plugin now, has an option for clipping plane. Has an option for the clipping plane, which is a draw distance. Type config to see that. Oh, so the command that I used, like, to... Words. In Windower, there is a plugin called config that allows you to change in-game options. Also, I think that was 2 mobs that I didn't count there. But in config, there is options to change, basically, like, in-game commands. Draw distance, obviously, frame rate, etc., etc. And I think I had upped the frame... Or not upped the frame rate. I think I had drastically upped the draw distance because, you know, it's a 30 FPS game. What the fuck? No big deal. And I think I may have forgotten about that little tidbit. Oh god, you're doing that spazzy thing again. Oh my god, so spazzy. I love it. Don't look at me like that. It'd be the funniest thing if these chests were public. And anybody could walk around and just follow you. It'd be the greatest damn thing. Here, you know, you want some bunch of random chests? Here you go, take it. Take the shit. Take all the things. Take them. They are yours. I don't even know how many I fucking have, man. But I don't care. I'm so close to completion. And then I can spend like 35 minutes running the bingo. Because that's fun. I don't have like the... Excuse me? There we go. Because I do not have the, I was gonna say the flight point. Oh god. What has become of my brain? Okay, so 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, 60, 65, 70, 75, 80, 85. I got 15 more, motherfuckers! We're almost done. We are almost done. We have almost completed this trial of patience above all. And I can see why doing this now, for the first time in several years, why this is probably the Dark Knight quest. Because, you know, Zayd just said to us, blatantly said that, you know, Dark Knight is a path of pain and anger, and you alone can follow it. So it makes sense that the quest is just the most brain-numbingly, monotonously painful, stupid bullshit kill quest of all time. Because it's monotonously painful, and oh my god, it's horrible, and Dark Knight better fucking be worth it. Kappa, kappa, kappa. No space. Please die in one hit. Thank you. Thank you for being kind in that regard. Don't you tell me you can't. I have to wait long to perform that action. I will spam this button until you listen to me. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. We only got 10 left, guys. We only have 10 left. It's the greatest thing ever. And then we run to Bedeau. Oh boy. Where the fuck is Bedeau? But seriously, like, where the fuck is Bedeau? Please. Please. Thank you. Level 1 Hornet. Ladies and gentlemen. That's like the type of thing, like almost feels like a Batman sort of thing, where it's like, you know, the dude's beaten down, like, massive supervillains, superpowered people like Bane, you know, he's gone toe-to-toe with Darkseid and somehow managed to survive because fucking plot armor and all that kind of stuff. And yet, you know, in a lot of stories, the most height of irony would be him getting killed by, like, some scrub rookie that gets a lucky shot off. Because, you know, that's pretty much how the world trolls you. Which is fine. You know, I mean, you know, the world is troll-a-lol-a-lol. That's kind of how they... Fuck, did I already count that or not? Ah, fuck it. Okay. Meanwhile, the people watching this would be like, you're already at 94! And I'm just like, I don't know. I need to find the tunnel worm. Also, my throat's starting to hurt because I'm talking for too fucking long. Damn it, Beavis. Oh, don't you even think about it. That is what I thought, good sir. How dare you try to run from me? I will decapitate you, stinky worm. I'm officially losing my mind. What's left of it, but I'm officially losing it. Okay, so 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, 60, 65, 70, 75, 80, 85, 90, 95. I got five more! Ah! Yay! All of this for a sword called the fucking Chaos Bringer. That's like hot garbage, but it has the most, oh my god, badass name of all time. I almost stabbed myself in the leg with a pen. Just in case it actually needs to be said, you know, public service announcement from SK. Do not stab yourself in the leg with a pen. It's not going to end the way you want it. I'm assuming there's going to be some kind of ink poisoning, not to say, not in the least of which would be involved with, you know, like, being stabbed with a pen. I'm sure that would be painful in its own right. Okay, got two more bitches. I got two more. Yee! Wow, yeah, I really did change the draw distance. Because I'm pretty sure I could actually see the entire zone. Like, what is... config? Holy shit. I'd never noticed... Adjust aspect ratio. If set to 2, will automatically determine the correct aspect ratio. Oh, no wonder the background thingy stopped working. And information. Frame rate only entered your value. Frame being the lowest and 0 being the highest. Aspect ratio explicitly defines the aspect ratio. Auto disconnect time, battle auto target. After engaging, clipping plane, the maximum map draw distance, 1 being the game's maximum setting. Clipping plane. set to 2 and enable footstep effects, both display and sound. 0 for uncapped frame rates. Huh. Interesting. I did not know that existed. Also, shit, was that 98 or 99? I'm gonna kill 2 more just to be on the safe side, because at this point I really don't remember, and the worst thing in the world would be if I were to go up there all the way to freaking Mado and find out, yeah, you missed, you had 99 mobs, not 100, because that has happened. You can look on the internet. That is a thing that has actually fucking happened before, which is just painful. Let's just put it that way. So yes, I'm at 100 mob motherfucker. Oh my lordy Jesus. That took, let me think. That was what, 13 minutes to get to the actual questy part? The questy-questy-son? And now, 13, 23, 33, 43. So that was like 35 minutes of just mindlessly grinding mobs. Oh boy, Final Fantasy XI, people! It's the stuff of beauty. Okay, now, do I have a home point anywhere that would take me to this? Oh my sweet baby Jesus. Okay. Config. Oh, sweet Jesus. Wow. So, what does this say? Config, what was this again? Flipping plane. Config. Flipping plane 1. I don't know what that did. I don't know what that did. But things just got real fucking slow, like across the board. Holy butts. Okay, let's try this one more time. I'm pretty sure that having clipping plane at 1 is basically causing my computer to have, like, a nervous breakdown. But to be fair, the game is a little bit, shall we say, unoptimized. Okay. Zolkheim. Do I want to run from Salbina? Definitely don't want to run from fucking Sabuta Baruta. Or Mara. Alshimolo. Definitely don't want to go to fucking Norg. Because that's in Paschal Marshlands, right, Bado? Because Davoy is in Jugner Forest, which is like Sandoria Town, and that's Paschal Marshlands, which is around Kondstadt, near... You know what, let's do it this way. And this is gonna sound weird. But I'm actually going to... Holy mother, okay. Travel... Sandoria. I'm actually going to travel to Sandoria. I'm going to travel to the exit. I'm going to run to the outpost in southern Sandoria because that's faster than going through northern Sandoria. I think there's like some sort of path that, at least in northern Gustaberg, that takes you from like the lowlands to like those upper land thing. I've seen somebody run it before. I saw Mr. Happy do it, but I'd be damned if I would be able to figure out exactly where the hell that thing is. I walked the entire coast. I have no fucking clue where it is. Like 0.0 clues. So I'm gonna run to the outpost. I'm going to see if I can teleport somewhere closer to Bado. Or Bade. I don't want to call it Bade because that gives a disrespect, shall we say. Now, like for instance, let's try this again. Config clipping plane 1. It didn't do anything. It's still running like it did before. Okay, you know what? Fuck it. This episode is going to be way longer than I wanted it to be. But then again, I just spent 35 minutes killing mobs completely. I don't want to say for shiggles, but... You know, it's in the general neighborhood of shiggles. Also, thank you for being Foggy Game, so you're not effing up my... This is why I like Sandoria, too, is that... It just loads better. Like, Gustaberg is nice in that kind of, like, you know, arid wasteland kind of thing, but Jesus Christ, it takes forever to load, man, because it's just... It's all just flat land and just rocks and dirt and... I mean, you know, it's not even a desert. Deserts have an air of, you know, mystery and mystique to them. Maybe that's just because I watched freaking Aladdin as a kid. I don't know. But Gustavberg's just rocks. It's just dry, like I said. It just, for some reason, Utah comes to mind. And that sounds unfortunate because that's going to be insulting Utahns. And I'm sure they have, that. Sure, it's a lovely state and they really enjoy being there, but it just seems... Yeah. Also, but look at that 60 FPS. When I'm not running at 0.2 frames per second, this is like the greatest thing since sliced bread. Okay, so... Come here. Hopefully this can, I can end this madness sooner rather than later, because I really do need to get dressed soon. Teleportation assistance. Yes. Bueno, Ranfar Norvelin? That's Jugner Forest. That's not where I want to go. North Gustavberg is not where I want to go either. Bubu Rima Peninsula. Marifod Mountains. Quifim. Lee Talor. That's Marifod Mountains. El Shimo Lo. Yatunga and Yehuder. Son of a fucking bitch. Oh, Lethane Plateau? No, no, that's... That takes me to Jugner Forest. God damn it, Beavis. Alrighty, it looks like it's... Yes, up and away. You're very... Very... All Mog Tablets have currently been found, so you may teleport to Valk... All Mog Tablets have currently been found, so you may teleport to Valkyrm Dunes at no charge. What the fuck are Mog Tablets? What is a Mog Tablet? I don't understand! What is it about this game that has this weird, like... Just... Bullshit bullshittery. And it's not even the bad kind of bullshit, I just don't understand. What is a Mog Tablet? When did they add this? I feel like such a scrub. Oh my god. 56 minutes in. This is gonna be a hell of a run to fucking Bordeaux, you know that? I'm determined though, I am bound and determined to get to the zone so I can complete this quest, so I can unlock Dark Knight and then probably never use it again. Because seriously, Jesus Christ. Chaosbringer, it is the greatest name for... I keep wanting to say, have I been saying Chaosbringer this entire time or Chaosbreaker? Because Chaosbreaker is the final weapon in Shining Force, which is also a really badass sword. It's a goddamn lightsaber. Best enjoy it. But, you know... The Chaosbringer, it's a really great name for a sword, and it's a really cool looking sword. I just wish it weren't horrible, but again, it kind of fits, it fits the thematic for the Dark Knight and yada yada, you know, hashtag where's Rachel. And that it's a really fucking painful, and I mean painful. It's like, just why? Why would you do this to another human being? Why? Because you're a Dark Knight, motherfucker. Learn to punch yourself in the baby maker for amusement, and then you will understand the ways of the Dark Knight. The insanity is slipping back in, guys. We are so close to completion, and yet so far away. Nah. Hello, Claudia. How are you doing today? That also sounds like a woman's name. Maybe I'm just reading it wrong. It's entirely possible I read it wrong. I looked at it for about half a second. So, 60 FPS is going perfectly fine here. What the hell is it about Gustavberg, and Bastok in particular, that makes it so frame rate delicious? It noms all the frames like it's, you know, peanut butter flavored Captain Crunch. And if you don't tell me that peanut butter Captain Crunch is the shit, then there's something wrong with you as a person. I mean, don't get me wrong, everyone's welcome to their opinion, that's fine. But your opinion is factually incorrect. I'm very sorry to inform you of this. Now, regular Captain Crunch, like, it's not bad. You know, I can take it or leave it. It tears up your throat if you try to eat it dry. And if you eat it with milk, you have a very, very short window with which to actually eat it before it gets all, like, soggy and disgusting. And then there's, like, the berry Captain Crunch stuff. I can never get into it. I've never been really one for, like, the super fruity, for the super fruity cereals myself. I've never been a big fan of them. I remember eating as a kid, like, Fruity Pebbles and all that kind of stuff, but... Oh, I'm grabbing the shit out of that. Go fuck yourself, Mount Music. Give me that survival guide. Okay, there we go. Now, back onto the cereal conversation. like, I mean, I remember eating Fruity Pebbles as a kid. I remember kind of liking Fruity Pebbles, but at the same time, it had the same sort of Captain Crunch problem where you had a very limited window with which to eat the pebbles, so to speak, before they just became a soggy mess of nothing and were just kind of like, you know. I guess I'm a fan of, you know, food that is kind of like crisp, you know what I mean? That has that kind of bite to it. Maybe not bite, but, you know, it has that sort of like Christmas? Really? It has that kind of Christmas to it, okay. It has that kind of crispness to it. You know, soggy foods, I don't do them. Like, I can't really eat oatmeal unless I'm really desperate, you know. I can't eat grits, even though I grew up in the South, because it kind of has the consistency of vomit. It doesn't really taste bad. It doesn't really taste like much of anything at all. But just the consistency of it kind of makes me want to puke just a smidge. How the hell did I not grab that survival guide? Like, can someone please explain this to me? Wait, did I get the survival guide? Who utilized a survival guide? What? Wait, did I actually get that survival guide beforehand? It didn't say I discovered it, right? Before me realized it, could I just have teleported to goddamn Kronstadt Highlands and just been good with it? Well, you have my apologies. The thing's running at an hour plus now, and I'm too damn invested to let it go now. Okay, so curiosity. Config flipping plane 5. That's what I was at before. Oh, okay. One is the max in-game setting, but you can actually make it a lot farther than the max in-game setting by making it. Okay. I get it. That's why Gustaberg was having a shit fit, because I had basically quintupled the frame rate of it. Okay. That makes sense. That is understandable. That also means I'm going to have to turn it down. Also, but that means the max clipping plane is fucking awful. I mean, I just... Like, did you see the way it looked before? Oh my god. Holy shit. Okay. Config. Flipping plane 2. Okay. I mean, that's not bad. That's still kind of shitty looking, but that's not bad. That's doable, I suppose. I mean, shit, Clipping Plane 1 had Basta going at, like, 40 FPS, so I don't know what the hell is the deal with it. Maybe too many buildings or something. I don't know what the hell the deal is with Gustaberg, though. That makes me a little sad, though. You kind of have to give up that sort of distance to get the 60 FPS quality. But again, the game was not optimized for that. The game came out in fucking 2002 in PS2 era, so it's not really optimized for these types of really long visuals and all that kind of stuff. And from my understanding, even games that were made much later that had a much, I don't want to say higher production value, but games like fucking Dark Souls, you know what I mean? That game is goddamn gorgeous looking. That game is one giant map. And its entire map is built on the idea of being able to stand at the top of, like, not Ottergan, what the fuck is that place called? Oh no, I know its name and I can't think of it. I mean, I never actually beat the game, but I've watched other people, because the gameplay was frankly infuriating to me. But I've watched other people beat the game, and it's a beautiful game, visually speaking. It's absolutely stunning looking. I'm not getting that outpost. I'm telling y'all right now, I'm not getting that fucking outpost. I will get it after I do this, maybe off camera, if I think about it, and if I'm not rushing out the door to get to work, because I really, really, really... really, really need to get to work very soon. But I am bound and damn determined to get this sick from Bedell. But, you know, Dark Souls, it had this sort of thing where, you know, you got to the bell tower of that whatever the fuck place it is. Damn it, I can't think of its name. But you could get to the top of the cathedral, ring the bell so it can... you get humanity and all that kind of stuff. And you would actually basically load the entire game. You could see the entire explorable world. And it was a beautiful sight to behold. It was amazing looking, and it also ran at like 5 frames per second while the damn thing was loading, because there was so much there. And that was a PS3 game. You know what I mean? That was a game from like, what, 2010, 2011? So that game had 8 years worth of technology on top of it, and it was still a bit of a frame rate issue. So it's to be understood that a game like this, which was made in 2002 and originally had a draw. I mean, the draw distance that we have now, this, you know, which I admitted I said was kind of a shitty draw distance, that's double what it used to be. Like, the max, I'm pretty sure that they actually doubled it for, what was it, the 360 release? They actually doubled the draw distance rate for either, it may have been for the 360, but I thought they also did it for the PC as well. They doubled that shit. I'm also running in the wrong direction. Damn it, me. They doubled the draw distance because at that point computers were powerful enough to be able to see as far as, like, that end rock over there, you know what I mean? And that was a great time, you know what I mean? So, you know, me bitching about, oh my god, I can't see the entire map from where I'm standing, kind of falls on deaf ears. I'm aware of the fact that I'm basically being a whiny little bitch in that regard, and that, frankly, having 60 FPS is worth not seeing the entire freaking map from the top of Gustaberg, because I like seeing 60 FPS more than seeing the entire map of Gustaberg, because Gustaberg kind of looks like shithole. I'm also running in the wrong direction again. So apparently you can actually zoom out on this. Holy shit, are you serious? Oh god, what did I do? Oh god, what did I do? Where'd the map go? Where did the map go? Guys, I broke the map. It's just gone now. That's what I get. See, someone suggested that I could actually zoom out the map and you can see the entire map and it's like cheating, yada yada yada. And I'm like, I don't need to cheat. The mini-map is good enough. Hey, but since I'm here, let me double check that. Well, I just broke my cheat. All right. Them's the way of things, I suppose. Also, did I like super zoom in? What the hell did I do? I don't understand. Whatever, fuck it. It can't be that important. I know where I'm going, I think. And we'll find out when I zone into the next area if that's correct or not. Oh, fuck. Oh yeah, I broke the fuck out of the map. Okay. Good to know. That's definitely going to be something I'm going to fix. So wait, where am I going? Go no touch you. Once you kill at least 100 enemies, but final blow with the sword, go to Bedell, you will get a cutscene. They reobtain. Oh man, reading all these things from like 2005. Oh, that's hilarious. Finals. So wait, what am I? What the hell am I doing? Blades of Darkness, give me the goddamn. Skills do not. Chaos Bringer. Skill of Valor. Up count towards kill. I can reset the kill count. Oh, baby. So, do I just zone into the. Do I just zone in? I totally could have gone to freaking Konstadt. I don't understand. Did I? I mean, I got more than 100 kills, right? I got 100 kills with the Chaos Bringer. I counted it. I was even on the safe side. What? I don't understand. That's not what I wanted to do, but that's okay. Please release me from this prison. I'm begging you, please release me from the madness that you have created and that I have created for myself. I just, I just want the Dark Knight quest, dude. I just want to complete the Dark Knight quest. I got 100 kills. Agoblix, man, help me, please. What do you want? You want to talk to me? I don't want to talk to you unless you got something. You want to take a hike, buddy? No. No, I don't want to take a hike. I want my goddamn Dark Knight quest. The boy, I don't care. Go. Okay. Why am I not getting the quest? Why? Apprentice. But I want... But... 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 Okay, I'm gonna kill one more mob. I'm gonna kill it outside. Maybe I just did something wrong. Maybe I'm at 99. I don't understand. I really aren't I supposed to just zone in and can fucking complete the quest? Because there's nothing I'm supposed to click. There's nothing there. Okay. Better fucking believe I'm bringing out trust. No, I can't bring out trust NPCs. I cannot bring out trust NPCs because if I do, they can get the fine and blow, which means that I'm not going to get what I need. No. Stop. I wish there was a way to actually stop a macro. Okay. Old Quadiv. Meet your doom. Are you serious? Oh, sweet Jesus. Am I going to actually die? And is this going to take like 16 fucking years? It's actually easier for me. Yeah, fuck this. It's actually easier for me to teleport back to North Gustaberg, kill like 3 more mobs, and then teleport back to Bedell. Yeah, fuck that. You are on your own, level 16 Quadiv. I'm sorry for picking a fight with you, but you are not what I need in my life right now. She also runs like an absolute idiot, but to be fair, if I was carrying like a 40-pound greatsword that's bigger than me, I would probably be running like an idiot too. Okay. I'm still not getting a cutscene, which tells me that I have not reached 100. let me go. Allow me to survive, please. Gustaberg, North Gustaberg, yes, just fucking take me to North Gustaberg. I don't care. Take me to North Gustaberg, let me kill like 3 more mobs, because apparently I didn't. Oh my god, am I missing something? Kill enemy? Doesn't matter. Once you go and unlock Dark Knight. So literally, I'm just there, right? Like, there's nothing in particular I'm doing, right? I'm just there. I walk in, I get the quest flag, and then I'm good, right? Like, I don't want to have to travel constantly back and forth. Oh my god, this is gonna take forever. This thing's level 8. God damn it. At level 29, I'm fighting a level 8, but sweet baby Jesus, this is gonna take 20 years. Why? Well, since I'm here, let me make sure. Okay. No need for a cutscene. Quest. Oh yes. No need for a cutscene. Quest. Blah blah blah. How did I not make 100 kills? How did I not make 100 kills? That is a crock of bullshit. Bind me, I swear to God. This fight has taken 2 minutes just by itself. I should have made this a two-parter. I should have just cut out the grinding. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna kill you as well. I don't care. Go fuck yourself, Stone Eater. I said... There we go. Just to make sure. Because tap dance and Christ. I can't use the job ability. Can't use the job ability. Can't use the job ability. So I'm just stuck here. Just waiting. The madness is seeping into my brain right now. You don't understand how pissed off I am. Why can't there be a goddamn quest indicating you sons of bitches? Truly, I am ready to be a Dark Knight because apparently I'm just... I brought this upon myself. I understand that. I'm almost level 30 by fighting level 1 mobs. I really have no reason to bitch. I'm fighting a goddamn video game. I definitely don't have reason to bitch. But this is infuriating. Just give me... Hi, Rock Lizard. How are you? How are you doing today? That's good to know. Okay. I'm teleporting back to Bedell. Hopefully I was only too shy. If it's any more than that, fuck this. I gotta get ready for work. Just let me go, please. Release me from this prison that is my brain. Revelant Durfland? Bedell. Yes. Just let me go. Please let this be what I need. Please tell me I was just one or two shy and that I somehow- How the hell did I miscount, though? Okay, let me zone out and back in, because I don't know if it's- if it lets you do that or not. If using the Moogle transport thing is the correct flag for it or not or something, I have no freaking idea. Alright, here's the moment of truth. Please, I beg of you. Alrighty, one last try. One last try. I just killed another 10 mobs in Ronflower here. Hopefully, I just miscounted by some sort of grievous amount. And if it's anything more than that, just F everything. About life. Please work. I'm begging you. Oh, thank God. As you have learned to bear the weight of the blade, it is the weight of the lives you have taken with it. I've bear the weight. Yeah. We're not going to discuss that. It's up to you to choose whether or not you will walk down the bloody path of the Dark Knight, but it might be wise to confront your past first before you make your decision. Your training to become a Dark Knight is already complete. As long as your blade craves for the souls of your enemies, our paths may cross again. Until then, farewell. Alright, so what is... Let's see what the hell this job emote is first. Job emote... So, you're Batman. That's adorable. Awesome. I'm Batchick. Fuck everything. Thank you guys for watching. I very much appreciate it. I am so terribly sorry that I have made you go through all this shit. But feel free to leave a like if you enjoyed it. If you didn't, I can totally 100% understand. If you want to see more, you're welcome to subscribe. If you want to send hate mail, gnarly, go for it. And I will see you guys next time. Peace out.